In a previous video, we've looked at all the cool stuff that is coming in .NET 10 in November for .NET MAUI. In this video, I want to specifically look at the media picker improvements that you've been long asking for. So we're going to check that out, and I need your help testing them before they're released in GA. So let's check it out. For those who are not familiar with MediaPicker, MediaPicker are the APIs in .NET MAUI that will allow you to capture an image or pick an image. So from the camera on your device or from the gallery on your device, so like your album that you have on your device, and you can just pick an image, pick a video on iOS, Android, macOS, and Windows, all the platforms that we're supporting. And then with that image or that video, you can do whatever you want in your app, right? So maybe you're posting something on social media because you're building a next social media platform, or maybe you're building a chat app and you want your users to be able to share images and pictures, which is, you know, it's 2025, you should be able to do that. Or maybe you have another crazy idea, let me know down in the comments, right? What you're building. So you can do all of that, but there has been some history there. MediaPicker has been around since the Xamarin days, and it had more functionality then than it has in .NET MAUI. Now, I'm not going to go into the whole history here. If you do want to know, let me know down in the comments or stop me somewhere and I'll tell you the whole thing over a drink. But what I want to focus on now is that we are taking some of those functionalities that you were used to into .NET MAUI, because that's what you've been asking for since forever, and we have been finally be able to do it. So I hope that you will be very happy with what you're seeing here, and most importantly, I want you to test this, because this is going to end up in .NET 10 previews. Actually, most of it is in the previews right now, and I want you to test it to make sure that we got it right before we're going to actually release it as the stable version in November, right? So test it, let me know down in the comments. Go to the Discord server, the MAUIverse Discord server that I'll link down below in the video description, because that is the new place where everyone in the .NET MAUI ecosystem is gathering right now. So make sure to be on there. Let me know what to do. Okay, with that, here we have like the GitHub issue, the epic improve modernize media picker, right? So a little bit of explanation, why are we doing this? What are the things that we are thinking about? And then under this, there is a bunch of issues that we want to do. First are the tasks, like, hey, we needed to modernize this, right? Both on Android, I think that was a community contribution, which is really amazing. There were newer APIs that we should use to make the media picker work, because there's new permissions, there's new APIs, you know, things have developed, and we were using obsolete ones and people were getting in trouble because it started falling apart and it didn't really work that well anymore. Same thing for iOS, like there were newer permissions, like you can have like the partial access to the gallery, right? You can only read pictures, you can only add pictures, all that kind of scenarios are there now since MediaPicker was originally introduced. Now we're using the modern APIs and you should be able to do all those scenarios inside of your app again. Then surface EXIF information. EXIF is the little metadata that can be inside of images, and you know, it will tell you how to rotate the image, how it should be like rotated. It tells you like where the picture is taken, with which camera. It can have all kinds of cool data. More about that later. Pick multiple files, right? Until now, you could just pick one file and that was it. One video, one image at a time. Now we enable multi-selection. Again, more on that in a minute. Image compression. So, you know, you can compress your image a little bit. You can say, yeah, I don't need it for like 100% quality, right? I want the image to be smaller and I'll just set it to 50%. That's good enough for whatever I'm doing. Image size. So you can say, hey, but we have amazing cameras these days, right? Like they can take pictures that you can print out and put on a billboard like on the road. But you might not need that, right? Maybe you're just doing this little avatar thing, this little profile picture, and it should be 100 by 100 pixels, right? So you can influence now the image size directly from here without needing to do that yourself. And then these one didn't make it for .NET 10 yet, so let me know if you want these for .NET 11, then we can look into it for that. The default camera, right? So do you want to open it from the front or the rear camera? If you want to, you know, if you have a selfie app, you always maybe want to show the front camera first. And correctly rotated image from the media picker too. I will get back to that in a minute as well. So that was the work that we've kind of like planned. You can see the little colors here. Green, it means that it's still open. Purple is already closed and merged and done. This one is an open PR right now, the rotated image. So I will show you that. Okay, so this is everything there is on GitHub. Let me close this and go to a little bit of code. So what I have here, I'm on my Mac today. I have these two sample apps open. It's the same sample app, but running on iOS and running on Android. And in the back, you can see the code base of dotnet MAUI, right? I opened up the repo, and this is a sample app that's included in the dotnet MAUI repository. And this is what I've used to actually build the thing, right? Super easy because we have all the samples here. I add the new options in there, and boom, I have a very easy app to test with. Also on my device because we're doing things with camera. So super cool. I'll look at a little bit of code a little bit later. But you know, the dotnet MAUI code base is pretty big, but you should be able to find it if you go looking for it. If you can't find it, let me know down in the comments and I'll help you find it. Okay, so when you run it, you have like everything, all the APIs that are called essentials, right? So if you want to see a video on any of these that you're seeing right here, let me know down in the comments. But we're interested today in the media picker, right? And here on Android, of course, like the exact same list, but now how it should look on Android, and we got the media picker here as well. So let's go into that. Here on iOS, and you see we have like a bunch of new options. You probably, this is the first time that you've seen the sample app, but this is a bunch, this is basically all the new options that you can see right here. Before it was just like pick photo, pick video, capture video, just the one picture or photo or video, and that was it, right? Because we didn't have multi-selection. So first thing here, multi-selection, you can still keep it at one. One is the default value. It will just have you pick one photo right here. There's a bunch of test images in here to test the rotation and whatever. So they look a little bit funny, but they're very useful. But you can just pick these wonderful flowers and you will just get that with the one pick, and you can see the dimensions and the size here, right? So that's about it. Now, if we up this, if we do three, I can pick up to three images. I can say one, two, three. And you can see the iOS UI automatically limits this, right? So I cannot pick any more. One, two, three. I can just do two, two. It's the maximum of three, right? And I can do three. Let's do three. And then I can do add. And you can see it shows it in a little list here. And I got all three of the image, right? So multi-selection implemented right now. Let me quickly show you. I'm not going to show all the features here between and Android and iOS. It works the exact same way because that's how dotnet MAUI does it. But here you can also say, hey, selection limit is three, pick photo, comes up here again with the same kind of like test images that I have right here. And I can do one, two, three, and you can actually not do more, right? Android shows it a little bit different. It's a little bit behind me here, but it says here at the bottom, like, hey, you can only do three, right? So I need to deselect one, select another one, and then I can continue. And also here, it comes up with the three images in the little list. Multi-selection, boom, got that down. Okay, what else do we see? Compression quality, right? So how this works is it will, if you do multi-pick, it will do it for all the images, right? So these kind of operations, it is also in the API documentation, it might slow a little bit down because you're now going to do image operations, right? And that is usually an expensive operation. So it might take a little bit of computing power, and it might take a little bit to load for you if you're going to do like pick, I don't know, 10 images and all set them to compression quality 10, right? Because it has to do a lot of work then. But what you can do here, actually, let me set it at 100 and do selection limit one for now. Just pick this. I think the flowers were pretty big, right? Like they were 4 megabytes. It's a little bit small here, but it says like 4 million bytes, 4 megabytes. And then if I put this down to like half, it's not going to be like one-on-one. If I set this to 50%, it's going to be 50% of the file size, right? That's not exactly how it works, but it should show smaller, right? So pick the flowers again. Here we go. And now it's 3 megabytes, right? It's not like impressive, but it took something off the file size. So there we go. That's implemented right now. I don't have any influence on how the compression quality is done. This just uses the APIs on the platform. It says like, hey, I want this thing with this quality. And it does that automatically, right? So not much influence from us here. You have to deal with what it kind of like gives you. Okay, we got that. Perfect. Back to 100%. Let me show the other one on Android right here. Then we have the max width and max height. So what this does, you can set the dimension for the maximum width or height or both. And then it will figure out like, hey, which one is the biggest one, right, that I can fit it into. And then the other one, it will leave it like that, right? Does that make sense? Like if you have like max width and max height to both do 100 and your image is like 100 and 150, 80 and 150, it will downsize it to 80 and 100, right? Or whatever, no, because it will scale correctly. I don't know. I don't know the math. you're probably smarter than me. You can figure it out, right? So it will take whatever the biggest size is and downsize it to that one. It will do that automatically without losing the compression, the quality, or if you also set the quality, you can really downsize that file size, right? So let's pick another one here. Actually, let's set it back to one. Doesn't matter if I just pick one, that's true too, but here we go. Let's scroll down a little bit. I got pictures for myself that I was testing with at a conference, so let's go with that one. I'm talking a little bit about Aspire here. And this one is 2084.48 with 15.36. So if I set this to max width, 500 right here, right? Max width 500, and I pick it again, then we should see that, whoops, which one did I take? This one. That it does it to 500, see? And it scales automatically, so it keeps the aspect correct, and then it sets it to 500 times 375, right? So I can take the other one into account as well, max height, so it's width and height. So if I set the max height to 100 now, you will see that the 500 will go down, right? Because it retains the aspect, and it will take whatever it kind of like fits in there. For the boundaries, right? Does that still make sense? So if I take this one again, now with 100, take this one, it should be much smaller. You can see the size like decreases dramatically as well, right? So this is really, really cool stuff, if you ask me. And it still goes pretty fast, even for one picture. Okay, so got all of that. Now, next thing, auto-rotate from EXIF. So like I said, metadata in the images, one of the metadata bits in there is how the image should be rotated, right? So the image could show, actually, it doesn't really show right here, but it could show like, hey, upright, but then the orientation says like, no, but the picture is taken like landscape, right? So it should be rotated this way, or it should be mirrored or whatever. It has this data. And until now, like, you know, if the picture showed up like, I don't know, rotated or upside down or whatever, you were on your own. And the cherry on the cake was that we would scrub the EXIF data from your image as well. So there was no way for you to kind of like determine how the image should be rotated, right? That was not cool. Now we're adding the option to auto rotate based on the EXIF information in the image. Of course, like if there's no EXIF information in the image, it's not going to help you, right? It doesn't know how to rotate it for you. But if it is in there, then it will do it automatically for you. So here in the gallery, you will see that all the images show correctly, right? But this is where the test images come in. And actually, the EXIF rotation is numbered. So it's just 1 through 8, I think. So you can see 1, 6, 7, 8 in here. And I think number 3 is like mirrored, right? So let's do that. Oh, it's mirrored and upside down, right? So you can see, hey, it showed okay in the gallery, which is probably what you want in this case. But there are cases where the EXIF information will tell you different. And this actually applies it from the EXIF. So here you got this like, hey, it's upside down and actually not mirrored. I don't know all the orientations from my head, but it's upside down at the very least. And if I do not auto rotate from EXIF and I pick 3 again, it will just show whatever it comes from the gallery, right? So this will help you rotate your images correctly. The other thing is preserve metadata. So if you're like, okay, this auto-rotate, you know, Gerald, nicely implemented, but I don't need that. I got my own logic, which is much, much better. Then you can say, hey, preserve metadata, default value is on, and it will keep the EXIF data in your image, right? So even if the EXIF data gets lost, this logic will see to extract the EXIF data, the metadata from your image and reapply it again to the resulting image that you get back from the media picker, right? There's no real sample for the sample app in here, but you know, you should trust that this works. So how to enable this? I just added a couple of new options to the media picker options. So this is how the API works. Simple as that. Media picker that pick photo async or pick video async. Actually, I changed it to photos and videos because we can now do multi-pick, right? And the old ones are obsolete. So keep that in mind if you're using this already and going to migrate to .NET 10. But now the media picker options have a bunch of new options. It's just an option that you can enable. So you can do compression quality, and that's a value between 0 and 100, right? 0 is least quality, 100 is the original quality. And it has a little description here, just set it to whatever you want. and that is what you'll get back. Maximum width and height that we just seen, hey, it can be like, it can be, is it nullable? Is the default value null? Then, you know, it's whatever the size is, it will, you will just get the original image. Otherwise, you will get like the maximum width, maximum height, which is just an integer that you can set right here. Rotate image, just a Boolean. Do you need to auto-rotate the image? Do we need to do that for you? Yes or no? And then the preserve metadata, again, a Boolean. Do we need to preserve that for you? Yes and no. Again, this has like the default value to true. Rotate has the default value of false. I kind of thought that made sense, so that you, you know, you don't have the performance impact whenever you're going to rotate and whatever. That's not suddenly forced on you. You really have to explicitly enable that if that's what you want. But otherwise, like, you know, you can just enable it. For the preserve metadata, that's not a expensive operation, so I thought that would be useful for you to have. So I set that to true automatically. Okay, now, with all that, so that's what I have to talk to you about, but I need your help, like I said, right? So I, this is in preview right now. Everything except the auto-rotate, is it the auto-rotate? Yeah, everything except the auto-rotate and preserve metadata is already in .NET 10 preview 6. Which should be around around the time that you see this. So go test all of that. So the compression quality, maximum size, multi-selection, go test that out and let me know on the images on Git, the issues on GitHub, preferably, or down below in the comments or wherever you can find me. Let me know if that works okay. The more we can test now, the more we can bugs we can get out before it launches actually in November when you have to start migrating your apps to .NET 10. The better, right? So start testing early, get me that feedback. I can get those bugs out before it's actually released and everyone will be happy, right? We'll have the best version of MediaPicker yet in .NET MAUI. So if you could do that, I would be very grateful. Thank you so much. As I mentioned already, we have a new MAUIverse Discord going on. So check out the video description. It's a Discord, already 150 plus people talking about MAUI, needing help, showing off their content, blogs, videos, whatever, showing off their projects, super cool stuff. So be sure to join that as well. And on the topic of EXIF information, I already told you like there's no great sample in here because it's not super easy to extract EXIF information from images, but working on the Media Picker, I thought, wouldn't this be a cool plugin to just have that EXIF information with a single API, extract that out of there? So I made a plugin and I made a video about that plugin, which you can see right here, and I expect you to see for you for that video in a second.